10 men were crossing a river, a famous old story. And in fact, Vidyaranya Swami in his Panchadashi, in trying to explain why the Upanishad keeps silence, he tells this story. 10 men were crossing a river. And then they crossed the river, it was pretty deep, and it occurred to some of them that, did we all cross or did anybody drown? So one of them said, let me count. Stand in a queue. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. No, that can't be right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh my God. The other person said, you're not doing it right. Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh my God, where's the 10th person? And they started crying. Oh, the 10th person, our poor friend, he drowned while crossing the river. He sat down and started crying in India. You know, they'll do like this. They say, ha ha kar karte. Now, ha ha kar in Sanskrit is just the opposite of the English ha ha. It's not laughing, it means alas. Yeah? Now, this person was walking by and he saw this group of people sitting and crying. And he asked him, what's wrong? Oh, we were crossing and our friend, the 10th person, he drowned. And this person quickly counted and he saw there were 10 people. And then he said, did you count? He said, we counted. How did you count? Well, we are telling you there is no 10th person. He's drowned, he's dead. Our poor friend is dead. Why? What's the point of these pointless questions? Now, that person says, calm down. Believe me, the 10th person is. Guru, you see, comes and says, God exists. I don't see it. Wait. Relax. The 10th person is. Calm down. Okay. I'll show you the 10th person. Okay. Count. Well, I've counted. No, count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And that man came and took hold of this person's hand and Dashamastvamasi, you are the 10th. And this person, for a moment, he was bewildered and he said, oh my God, I am the 10th. Let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the other person came, let me try it, 10. And the 10th person has been found and they're very happy and thank the person. Now, what's the point of the story? Now we're going to apply it. Okay. You remember the 5 sheets? Body. The physical body, you feel it. The Upanishad says, go deeper. Feel the breath within. The pranamaya kosha. Okay, I feel it. Close your eyes and feel the mind within. Thoughts. Perceptions. They're coming in the mind. Emotions. Memories. Okay, I feel that too. Go deeper. The intellect. The ego. I am Mr. or Mrs. or Miss so-and-so. I understand. 2 plus 2 is 4. This is the ego. This is the intellect. Vijnanamaya kosha. I understand. Go deeper. Beyond that, you will find blankness. Just now, if you see, beyond the buddhi, it's nothing. Blankness. That blankness is the anandamaya kosha. Now, what we are doing, the mistake which we commit, is annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, anandamaya kosha, and some atman. One more we are trying to look for. Never find it. The 10th person is not there. There you have to intuitively grasp the one who watches these 5 koshas. You know, you can't look for one more atman beyond the anandamaya kosha. You'll never find it. You are the one who is watching, experiencing. That one which is watching and experiencing these 5, you have to take that turn there. How do you take that turn, Swamiji? It can't be put into words. It is instinctive. It is intuitive. If you do that, as the MC said at the beginning, Jivan Mukta. Nishchala Tattve, Jivan Mukti. So that Nishchala Tattva is within us, the unchanging reality. That is watching these 5 koshas. That is experiencing these 5 koshas, identifying itself with the 5 koshas and saying, I am so and so, this limited person. But actually, it is free of these 5 koshas. The body may change, grow older, and die. You exist. Breathing, it's a very good thing to breathe, necessary. But one day it will stop. You exist. Mind, whether it's thinking, dreaming, or stopped in deep sleep, you exist. Same for the buddhi. Beyond the darkness of deep sleep, And one of our Swamis, he wrote a poem in Malayalam. I wish I could read Malayalam. Beautiful, evocative title, The Midnight Sun. The Midnight Sun. You can understand? In the darkness of deep sleep, if there is a sun, a consciousness. So, that is a taste of the Atman, that which watches the five sheets. If you try it, sometimes there are unexpected side effects. Some people have said, Swami, it makes me feel scared at that last moment. Swami, it makes me feel sick. I feel giddy if I try that turn. But that is the teaching of the Upanishad. You are the tenth. Here literally does not mean the tenth. The one which watches the five sheets, you are that.